Hello, folks. Here's Professor Francisco Gomes. In this first series of 7 videos, I'm going to explain my experience with intermittent fasting. So let's get to it. As I said before, in this series of 7 videos, we're going to discuss about my experience with fasting. And the first topic, we're going to discuss why I started fasting. What were the reasons that I decided to embark in fasting since 2014? Most of the people, when we think about fasting, they always related to weight gain or weight loss or with problem with obesity. I never had any issues with obesity. My decision to start fasting was due to another medical condition. The second topic, we're going to discuss the type of fasting that are currently being used today. There are several styles of fasting, and we're going to explain the different variations of it. On the third video, I'm going to explicate and elaborate how I'm fasting. What is my weekly schedule? How often I fast during the week? For how long? And what are the foods and drinks allowed? By definition, when you are fasting, you basically are not eating. So the recipe of doing fasting is very simple. There is no calorie counts. There is nothing to worry about what you eat, what you should not eat. But there are some situations that you have to eat. So, like sometimes you're taking a medication and you cannot have it on an empty stomach. So you have to eat something. So we are going to go in more details about how I deal with these situations. And on the fourth video, we are going to explain what were my benefits doing fasting, especially in my case. This could be a whole other video explaining the general benefit, general health benefit of fasting for several conditions. But we're going to go into detail what my specific benefits while I did my fasting and why I'm still doing fasting. We will see my results according to my initial medical conditions. On the fifth video, we're going to discuss the fast side effects. So there are some side effects of fasting. I did have some side effects. One of those inevitable side effects is hunger. So to me, it was something that I was worried about, if I could not deal with the hunger. At the beginning, I might share with you that it was tough. I was scared with the hunger, and I was afraid if I would faint, if I would not be able to do the period that I decided to do, the whole 24-hour fasting without eating. But with time, I developed some strategies that we can pretty much deal with hunger. And today, hunger is not a problem whatsoever. I can deal pretty much with hunger there. I still feel hunger. Of course, it's an instinct. It's an adaptation that is very useful for animals. So if there is no hunger, you'll die of starvation. So, but today, hunger is the least of my concern when it comes to fasting. And I'm going to share with you what I did and what I'm doing to deal with hunger. A big part, I can assure you that the big part of the hunger problem is not in your stomach. It's in your brain. It's in your head. On the penultimate video, we are going to compare fasting versus other diets. There are way too many diets that we could discuss, but for the sake of time, I'm going to focus on only those main diets: ketogenic, paleo, vegan, and Mediterranean, and do a comparison between those diets and fasting. What are the advantages and the disadvantages of doing one of those diets compared to fasting? So basically is a pro and cons of fasting and of fasting and one of these diets. We can, of course, merge them. You can do a combination of fasting and other diets, because you cannot be always on a fast state. If you'll be in a fast state, basically you are starving and will eventually die. So you should decide what type of continuous diet or continuous food regimen you are in, and adopt and insert the fasting into your weekly schedule. Lastly, to conclude, we have to share some concerns and discuss who should not fast. You should always talk to your doctor and or dietitian if you attempt fasting. So in general, fasting is a pretty safe strategy. So there are situations like just to cite one, for example, if you have diabetes and you're taking insulin, so it's very dangerous to do fasting without a medical and a dietitian support, because insulin will take your sugar from your blood and shut inside your muscle, and then you can faint, you can even enter in a state of coma. So if you have diabetes or other medical conditions, you are too frail, if you are too lean, and the other medical situation, you should contact a physician and your dietitian. Now let's jump into the first video. Why fasting?